practice paper 1 part 3. That means we have already completed section A, section B, section C. Now we are going to do section D. Question number 21. Draw the graphs of the following equations on the same graph sheet. X minus y equal to 0, x plus y equal to 0, x equal to 2. Also find the area enclosed between these lines. Means three lines area will be the three lines if we have to draw on the graph, and the area should be find out. What is the first equation? Solution part is this only. We have to write the equation first. X minus y equal to 0. That means x and y are equal. So make a table directly. We can write 102. The same values for y also 102. X plus y equal to 0. So that meaning is for what? For y, y equal to minus x. So again, one more table. When we are putting x equal to 0, it will be minus 0. 0 is not having sign. So 0, 0 only we will write. X equal to 1, then y will be minus 1. X equal to 2, then y will be minus 2. Again, x equal to 2. This is only linear equation in one variable only. Such equations, if you are getting for getting the solution, I already told that x value we should write first 2. You will write 3 times. Correspondingly, y value we will write 1, 0, and another one is 1 positive and 1 negative value. Now let us see the graph. First we have to draw the x and y axis, then we have to plot each one by one line. We have to take its coordinate also we have to take. So the first line, x minus y equal to 0, so we have taken 0 0 1 1 2 2. So always don't forget to name the lines x minus y equal to 0. Similarly, second line, x plus y equal to 0, one more line we got, the one of the end we should label the line, so x plus y equal to 0. The third line is what? X equal to 2. So you will get it is parallel to y axis. Now we should find the triangle, and in addition to this, I want to remind you that we should write the axis also, what is the scale we have taken. Now we have to find the area of the triangle which is enclosed by the three lines. That means area of the triangle here O I'll take, and this A and B. If you consider this triangle OAB, this is the line. OA means the line x plus y equal to 0 we got. OB we got x minus y equal to 0. And the third side we got from the equation x equal to 2. So this is the area enclosed by these three lines. Now we have to find the area of this triangle. So base is what? AB as the base we can take. So actually we have to count the units now. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 unit as the base, and height is this only because you know that it is 90 degree. So 1 and 2 as the height. Now we can see what is the area of the triangle. Base we got 4, height we got 2. So we have calculated base 4, height h. So area of the triangle OAB equal to half into 4 into 2. That is 2, 2 will get cancelled. So 4 square unit is the answer. So when the questions are asked, they answer that one, because the mark will be distributed in a marking scheme like this only. So 3 lines, you may get 3 mark, and the last answer is for this, that is area of the triangle. So draw neatly and label the names of the lines also. Don't forget that. Next question. In a certain test, Nikita scored marks X and Y respectively in mathematics and English. If her total marks is 70, then form a linear equation in two variables for this. Also draw its graph. Find graphically her score in other subject. If the score in mathematics is 30, then we should find what is in English. Score is in English is 20, then correspondingly mathematics we have to find. This is the question. Now let us see the solution. According to the question, sum of the two scores is 70. So we will take as x plus y equal to 70. So what is x here? X is the mark scored in mathematics. X equal to score in maths. And y equal to score in English. So we got x plus y equal to 70 for y equal to 70 minus x. So we will find out the solution now. X and y there, usually we should find one when x equal to 0, what is y, and we should find the other solution as when y equal to 0, what is x. So we got 0, 70, 70, 0, and one more value we should find out, anything you can find. So 40, 30. So here these are the three solutions for the graph. we have to complete the graph. As you know that it is x and y axis only, but the x axis score in mathematics we have used, so write here score in max. Similarly, score in English on y axis. Now plot the points and draw the line. We will get a straight line like this, and on the line we should label that one x plus y equal to 70 and also the coordinates. After that, they asked in the question that from the graph we should find out the score in max is 30, then what is the score in English? So we already know that max is in x, on x axis only, so 30 we have to keep and take the draw the perpendicular to the given line like this. We have to keep the scale on 30 and draw a dotted line then, and where it touches from there we have to draw another perpendicular to y axis for calculating the value of English. So we got when max is 30, English is 40. Since it is asked the score will be in English is 40. Similarly, when the score in English is 20, and what is the score in max? So from the 20, we have to draw a perpendicular to the line. From there, another perpendicular we have to draw for x-axis. The corresponding value is 50. So in the question paper, it is asked that from the graph you have to read. So don't forget to plot the lines like this. We must draw the perpendiculars on the graph. And finally, we should write the answers like this also. From the graph, score in max 30 means English equal to 40. Score in English is 20, then max is equal to 50. Next question. Rahim had a sandwich which was a square in shape. Instead of eating his sandwich alone, he decided to divide it into four equal parts and share with his three best friends, Ram, David and Manjeet. Explain how Rahim divided his square sandwich into four equal parts. And also one more question it is asked. What quality of Rahim is depicted in the above question? Nowadays this question is eliminated because it is a value based question. Previously it was there in the question paper. That is why I have given here. Now what is the question it is given? A sandwich is in the square shape, and it is he wants to divide it into the remaining his three friends also. How he can divide the square sandwich into four equal parts? Now let us see the solution. Given A, B, C, D is a square. Square properties all we can write also. It will be helpful for while writing the proof part. Angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D equal to 90. That means all the angles are equal to 90 degree. AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to DA. That means all the four sides are equal. And also we know that the diagonals of the square are equal, and therefore half of AC equal to half of BD. That means diagonal bisect each other also we can use, since it is a special type of parallelogram. What is to prove? Divide into four equal parts. The square should be divided into four equal parts. Now we can see the proof. Now we have to show that all the four triangles are congruent. Now what is the criteria we are taking? Means AOB and COD, the both the triangles in opposite side we are taking. So triangle AOB and COD, AB equal to CD, that means opposite sides are equal, means all the four sides are equal only, it is sides of the square only. Next, AO equal to CO, OB equal to CD. What is the reason this one? Because half of AC equal to half of BD. That means diagonals are equal, half of equals are also equal. So we have got three sides. So the triangle AOB congruent to triangle COD, SSS criteria. Now in triangle AOB and COB, congruent means adjacent triangles we are taking. Now we are taking opposite triangle and we have proved they are congruent. We are taking adjacent triangle, then we have to prove that again it is a congruent. So AB and CD in the figure itself you can see equal side, and OB equal to OB, the common side. It is common to both the triangles. Again, OC and OA are equal. So we have got that diagonal bisect each other property. So here we got three sides again. So these two adjacent triangles are also congruent. So triangle AOD congruent to triangle COB. And similarly, we can take AOB and AOD also. So we have got a opposite. This we have proved first. Again, we have proved this. Now, similarly, we can prove this also. So, by using 1, 2, 3, what is the conclusion? We can say all the four triangles are congruent. Actually, the chapter 9 is deleted. If everything is congruent, means two triangles are congruent, their areas are also equal. So, that shows that it is divided into four equal parts. Now, value is asked. Now, presently, this part is deleted from the means last 2-3 years it's not there. So still if the question it is asked, so we are writing that Rahim is compassionate and believes in sharing. Next question now. Construct the angle of 22.5 degrees. So for the steps we have to construct 90 degrees, then 90 degrees to be bisected 45 degrees, then again it will be bisected for getting 22.5. So see the rough diagram. First we have to construct a 90 degrees. 90 degree constructions you know very well, and if you use the bisecting property, 90 will be bisected and you will get as a 45 degrees. So that means up to here it is 45, both the parts are equal to 45. We need 22.5 only, so one more bisection to be done. So here we have to do the bisector. So this is 22.5. So steps we have written, we are not written in a detail, just write a construct 90 degree and construct a 45 degree, then construct 22.5 degrees. So what is the name of the angle we have, we can give here? Means I'll write here O, A and B. So construct 90 degrees such that angle AOB equal to 90, right? Next 45 degrees such that, which is the angle AOC, angle AOC equal to 45 degrees. Again construct 22.5 degrees such that, which is the name of the angle, one more letter we required, that is AOD. So we got 22.5. 90 by 2, that is 45. 45 is again bisected, so 22.5. So first we have to draw AOB 90 degrees. So what we should do, draw the semicircle. The same radius we have to make two equal cuttings. From there another two more arcs we have to draw, and through that we have to draw. So we will get angle AOB 90 degrees. Now this radius AOB to be bisected, this radius means here again you have to keep the compass and more than half to be taken, then bisection to be done, you will get angle AOC. After getting AOC, what we should do, again AOC to be bisected. So this is the radius for us, right? So again bisected, it will be 22. So here first we have to mark 90 degree, again 45 degree, then the last we have to show 22.5 degree. So which is the 22.5 degree? Angle AOD. Respectively, we have seen the names in the steps of construction. AOB 90 degree, that is bisected, then we are getting angle AOC, that is 45 degree, again bisecting, and we are getting angle AOD equal to 22.5. With this, today's class I'm winding up. Thank you.